Blackstone presents Michael Curtiz, A Life in Film, by Alan K. Rode. This book is read by Grover Gardner. For Mom, who first told me about Hollywood. Prologue. People began queuing up on Thursday afternoon, March 2, 1944, to secure a bleacher seat on Hollywood Boulevard for the 16th Annual Academy Awards. Although the banquet to bestow the coveted statuettes had become an increasingly popular event, the Academy of Motion Picture Arts and Sciences had never produced anything on the scale of this evening's opus. The local police couldn't handle the mass of fandom and photographers that spilled out in front of Grauman's Chinese Theater. Louis B. Mayer, Hollywood's top mogul, donated the services of his studio police chief, Whitney Hendry, along with a contingent of Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer cops to provide crowd control. Accustomed to the mundane routine of waving Mickey Rooney's convertible through the front gate at Culver City, MGM's finest couldn't distinguish some of the Hollywood luminaries from the surging hoi polloi. The resultant heavy-handed treatment didn't go over well. Variety reported the following day that many of the stars found themselves pushed around by minions of the law and expressed their chagrin. Adding to the general confusion was the fact that no one had thought to assign valets to whisk away the long line of cars disgorging movie royalty curbside. George Jessel, America's Toastmaster, nervously worked the red carpet amid a gaggle of late-arriving movie stars, including Humphrey Bogart and his wife, Mayo Metho, who struggled through the crush to enter the theater by the 8 p.m. start time. What had been a self-congratulatory gathering for industry elites in the swank environs of the Ambassador or Biltmore Hotels was being reinvented this night as the premier public event of the motion picture industry at Sid Grauman's 2,200-seat movie palace in the heart of Hollywood. With the war's outcome still in doubt, the 16th Academy Awards discarded the insular dining format for a ceremonial spectacle dedicated to the U.S. military. The 1944 Academy Awards program opened with a U.S. Army-produced short film saluting Hollywood's mobilization to support the war. Susanna Foster, the star of Universal's 1943 version of Phantom of the Opera, sang the national anthem. The audience was thick with uniforms. Colonel and Mrs. Frank Capra, Colonel and Mrs. Daryl Zanuck, Captain and Mrs. Ronald Reagan, and so on, along with lesser mortals from all branches of the services. Jack Benny would host the second part of the ceremony. I am here through the courtesy of Bob Hope's having a bad cold, on a worldwide shortwave radio hookup broadcast to the U.S. Armed Forces. The Academy's president, Walter Wanger, intoned in the program, "The motion picture industry places above all other considerations service to our nation." The nominated films in the different categories offered emblematic testimony to a world at war, in which we serve Five Graves to Cairo, Destination Tokyo, Sahara, So Proudly We Hail, This Is the Army, Hangmen Also Die, This Land Is Mine, Crash Dive, Stand By for Action, Commandos Strike at Dawn, Corvette K-225, and Bombardier, among others. Half of the 10 Best Picture nominees were associated with the ongoing conflict. Studio insiders and local bookies piled change on either Casablanca or the distinctly non-war-themed Song of Bernadette for Best Picture. The evening's program picked up momentum after a series of technical awards were acknowledged by polite applause and brief expressions of gratitude by the winners. Greer Garson's embarrassing 5-minute monologue after receiving the Best Actress Oscar for Mrs. Miniver the previous year eliminated any possibility of Stemwinder acceptance speeches by tonight's winners. The director Mark Sandrich was tapped to present for Best Director. The nominees included some of the top film directors in Hollywood: Ernst Lubitsch for Heaven Can Wait, George Stevens for The More the Merrier, Henry King.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.